Pfizer COVID-19 vaccine produced 4.6 times more antibodies in participants. Pharmaceutical company Pfizer revealed the recent findings on its COVID-19 vaccine. The vaccine candidate called BNT162b1 has been tested in phase 1 of 2 trial among 45 healthy adults. The vaccine uses mRNA or a bit of genetic code of SARS-CoV-2. It cannot cause infection but can alert the immune system of an invader. This preps the body to produce correct antibodies before the real virus can strike. The trial was a placebo-controlled, observer-blinded dose escalation study. Participants were aged from 18 to 55 years and received either the mRNA vaccine or a placebo. Two doses were administered to participants with an interval of 21 days. Three doses were assessed in the study: 10 micrograms, 30 micrograms, and 100 micrograms. Among three doses, the 30 microgram dose was found most optimal in safety and efficacy compared to the other two. The 10 microgram dose produced less side effects, but its efficacy was lower than 30 micrograms. The 100 microgram dose had a higher chance of causing reactions without giving significant benefits. The second 100 microgram dose was no longer given to participants due to adverse reactions. Dr. Amesh Adalja, infectious diseases expert at the Johns Hopkins Center for Healthy Security, said, "The study provides more evidence of mRNA candidate COVID vaccines to induce neutralizing antibodies after two doses." The authors showed that the SARS-CoV-2 neutralizing antibodies were substantially better compared to those who received placebo. According to Medical Express, the neutralizing antibody levels were from 1.9 to 4.6 times greater in subjects than in controls. The results show that mRNA vaccines could induce favorable immune responses at right doses. However, the authors said that phase 3 clinical trials would still be needed. Phase 3 trials would tell them the consistency of the vaccine safety and efficacy in a larger population. These trials would also be required for regulatory approval, especially in Europe and the US. Dr. Adalja, who was not a part of the study, hopes that the vaccine is effective. "Even if antibodies have been produced, they must be determined useful against the wild virus. This is because several factors may change the dynamics. Data from phase 3 trials will provide better understanding how COVID-19 vaccines work in real-world settings. These trials often provide more solid results than in phase 1 and 2. The phase 1 of 2 results of BNT162b1 were published in the journal Nature.